Good morning. It is Monday, the 12th of March 2018, and this is your local news for today. Measures will be taken against those who received a home from the state but don't use it. Rice farmers in Koroni are switching over to fruit growing. Youth Parliament worries about the effect of strike of bus and boat operators on educational process and higher vocational education for public service. The Ministry of Social Affairs says that actions will certainly be taken against those who have assigned a home, but for some reason do refuse to take up residence. In the National Assembly, President Bouterse made it clear during the budget debate not to be happy with the many empty houses on premises with high weed, while others yearn for a home. There have been a number of housing projects in the past few years delivered by the government at Hanaslus, Richelieu, Leidingen, de Ringweg, and other parts of the country. There will also be follow-up projects this year, but these issues should be examined more closely in the allocation of the dwellings. The Ministry of Social Affairs will take the necessary steps to reclaim these empty homes. Most of Koroni's rice farmers have switched to fruit growing. They have done this because fruit growing is cheaper. Ronnie Fleet is one of the farmers who recently started planting passion fruits. Fleet says that fruit growing is more environmentally friendly than planting rice. According to him, Koroni should become the fruit district of Suriname. Growing healthy and organic fruit should become the hallmark of the district. Koroni is now in a phase where small entrepreneurship is stimulated. The local people are working hard to make a contribution to the economy of the country, Fleet emphasizes. It is a thorn in the eye of the Youth Parliament that the educational process is stagnated because of the strike of the bus and boat owners responsible for school transport. The president of the National Youth Representation, Kelvin Koniki, says that as a result, the right to education is again affected. Koniki fears that with this unrest, the educational result will be negatively affected. This makes it more difficult to check for any other causes for bad educational results. It is important that agreements are observed so that school transport can be normalized and continued, says the president of the Youth Parliament, Kelvin Koniki. And on October the 1st, 2018, the Higher Vocational Education Training for Civil Servants at the Ministry of Home Affairs will begin. According to the minister, Mike Nur Salim, civil servants should be able to follow a higher vocational training. Currently, it's limited to middle vocational education. The minister had put a working group to work to do the study for possibilities for higher vocational education level. Nur Salim further says that the demand from the civil service for further study at higher vocational education level was high. The minister reports that the so-called FISO system also requires that civil servants have to be trained at a certain level if they want to make a promotion. The minister indicates what the officials can achieve by obtaining one HBO civil servant diploma. And with this, we've come to the end for the local news for today. Be sure to join us tomorrow for a new edition. Bye-bye.